Hey guys, I'm Pixel Dan, and this is a review of the Nickelodeon Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Baxter Stockman-Fly. That's right, it's probably one of the most iconic representations of Baxter Stockman. Everybody remembers him as a fly from the original cartoon series. And luckily, we got to see that very mutation in the new Nick cartoon, and Playmates has given us a brand new action figure, so let's check him out. As you can see, Stockman-Fly comes on that new style blister card packaging, featuring that bright yellow and green color scheme there, with an image of all four turtles straight out of the cartoon series in the upper right-hand corner. Also, I love the little tagline under his name there, Turflytle's ultimate superhero enemy. That's fantastic, especially for fans of the show. And then, of course, when you flip that around to the backside, we get ourselves a brand new bio for Baxter Stockman in fly form, along with an image straight out of the cartoon series. And down below that, we get a look at some of the other figures that are currently available in the Nick Turtles lineup. Alright, so this is the second version of Baxter Stockman we've actually received in this lineup, which is, that's pretty cool. I think the only other time that's happened was around the 2003 series, so it's pretty neat getting two different versions of Baxter in this line. Of course, the first one we got was the humanoid version, but he was wearing that big mechanical suit, that mouser-type suit that we saw him with in the cartoon series for an episode, and of course, when you stand these guys side by side, that really kind of brings out those scale issues once again with that first Baxter. The fly one here is actually a much more accurate scale, as he stands about the right size you would expect a human character to stand when up against the turtles. He's about a whole head taller than them, which is really nice, and he still has a bit of a scrawny appearance because he's a very skinny guy. So I think the scale works out rather well with this particular character. So let's go ahead and look at the actual design of this figure. Now, Baxter's fly look in the new cartoon series is very grotesque. They really kind of took that whole fly look and ran with it, but I love it. He still has that fly-like appearance, but it's got its own uniqueness to it that makes him stand out and still different from the original version. So you can see he's got that very fly-like head there. And there's a lot of great sculpted details going on. You got these great little antennas sticking off the front. You got that nasty-looking mandible jaw there. But you still have that tuft of human hair sitting on top of his head, which is really cool. And then, of course, he's got those big bug eyes. And I'm going to talk a little bit more about those, but let's look at the rest of the figure real quick. He's wearing that bright pink shirt that Baxter is known for in the series. And you can see he's got lots of little barbs and everything kind of poking out of his body, sticking through his shirt, and going all down his arms. Now the paint job is a bit minimal on this, which is what we've come to expect from the Playmates Nick Turtles toy line. It's honestly not too bad on this guy, but there are small little details on there that are unpainted, such as all of those barbs that are kind of sticking off of his body there, all the way down his legs. So the leg ones are painted blue like his jeans, the ones on his shirt are pink like his shirt. But there's still a lot of great sculpted details going on here, and for what it's worth, there's quite a bit of actual paint deco, so there are multiple colors that are used, from the brown that's used on his fly-like skin there, and it's even a nice kind of glossy brown when compared to the brown that's used on the loafers on his feet, which are much more of a flat brown, so that's nice because they stand out as different from one another. Then his jeans are done in that dark blue color, and of course we even have kind of the black hair that's sticking off the top of his head. Now let's go back to those eyes. I don't know how well this actually stands out on camera, but the eyes are painted wonderfully. First of all, it looks like they are molded in a clear green plastic. The same that's used on the wings that are on his back that we're going to take a look at in just a minute. So the little eyelashes and everything sticking off the eyes are done in this really cool translucent green. But the eyes themselves have this amazing glossy finish on them where they've kind of got like this metallic yellow-green mix that really gives them a realistic bug eye look. I mean, these have this really great shimmer to them that really make them stand out, and it brings the whole figure together. See if I can get a good look at that shimmer for you guys, but it's just awesome. The fly eyes just look so cool on this guy. Now, while the eyes are definitely a highlight on here, I do have one minor little complaint with the paint. Of course, aside from the fact that we've got some unpainted spots, it does look like the body itself is probably molded in a blue plastic because you'll notice up here at the joints, The red or the pink of his sweater is kind of peeling off a little bit, and you can see the blue kind of coming through underneath it, at least on mine. So I don't know if that's going to be something that's on every one of these figures, and it's not too bad. It's just kind of at the joints there, but it's just something definitely to point out so that you guys are aware of. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look at the articulation on Baxter here. The head is on a joint at the neck that allows it to look left and right, but also up and down. It's on a ball joint, so look at that. You can really rotate the head all the way around, which is perfect for this fly character because you can get those really great kind of cockeyed fly looks there, you know, where he's cocking his head to the side. You can even get him kind of looking upwards for some flying poses. I love that. It works perfect for this guy. Other than that, we got those standard kind of ball-like joints at the shoulder, so the arms can go upwards, forwards, and backwards. There's no other articulation in the arms, so there's no swivels, no elbow bends, or anything like that. We have a swivel at the waist. We have the same hinge-type joints at the thighs there, so legs can go outwards. They can move forwards and backwards, as well as swivel there. But then there's no other articulation in the legs. But he's not in too bad of like a pre-stance or anything, so he actually stands up pretty well. He balances even with the wings on his back and the bigger head. So let's look at those wings. They are made of a softer plastic, and it's that same green translucent plastic I pointed out on his eyes there. And you can see really great little details, look just like fly wings on his back. And they are on nice little ball joints here. So you can swivel them, you can bring them forward. That way you can get them posed with him kind of laying down on his back. You can get them in great flying poses so the wings are spread out. They are really nicely done. And I actually really like the translucent look for them. Gives them much more of a fly look, having the clear wings there, which is very cool. You might notice that the one wing's a little warped coming out of the box, but it's just because it's that softer plastic. Shouldn't be too big of a deal just to kind of bend that back in place and not really a problem. So, articulation is pretty good on this guy. It's about what we'd expect from a lot of the villains in the TMNT toy line, so there's no elbow bends or knee bends or anything like that, but the wings are great and the head articulation is fantastic. Now, one of the reasons I really like that head articulation is because if you do have a clear flying stand of some sort, note that this figure does not come with a flying stand, but if you have a flying stand, you can actually bend his head looking up, you can kind of bring his legs down, and you can get him in that really great kind of weird hunched over flying pose that we often see him do in the cartoon series, and it looks awesome! It's so satisfying being able to pose the figure this way. I kind of wish the flying stand came with the figure, but seriously, if you guys have one or can get one, it's a great way to display this figure. Now, Baxter does come with one little accessory, which is a really fun one. He's got this little chocolate bar, because flies love their sugary candies. It's pretty great. You can get him to hold it in his left, more human-like hand there, and you kind of have to squeeze it into his fingers, but they do get a really nice, tight, grasping grip around the chocolate bar there. And with the way his articulation functions and the way you can turn his head, you can actually get him looking like he's eating that bar. Nom 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 nom. All right, guys, it's comparison time. Here is a look at the new Baxter Fly standing alongside the vintage Baxter Fly. Now that vintage figure is one of my favorites from that lineup, and it's kind of cool looking at these guys side by side so you can see the difference that they went in direction as far as his look goes. But honestly, the two figures hold up pretty well next to each other, and they even are similar as far as like the amount of paintwork that's done on them. So kind of neat just to look at these guys side by side here. And here he is with a whole bunch of other Baxter Stockman figures! It's Baxter Palooza! So there you go, my friends. There is a look at the brand new Baxter Stockman Fly figure from the Nick Turtles toy line. Minor little gripes aside, such as the lack of articulation at the elbows and the knees, and the unpainted little details on the figure, those are just common things that we see in this lineup so far, and honestly, Baxter Stockman really stands out as one of the better figures that has come out of this line in some time, I must say. I really like the look of this guy. I like the way he looks in the new series. I think it was translated very well into action figure form. The sculpt looks awesome, especially on that head, and I just love those bug eyes. Very, very cool. I think it's awesome getting this guy posed in a flying pose with a flight stand, and it's pretty sweet matching him up with your Shredder, your Bebop, and Rocksteady to create one classic TMNT enemy team. So Baxter Stockman is starting to hit store shelves right now, so happy hunting, my friends. Oh, and hey, if you haven't already, be sure to check out my interview with Playmates Toys from Toy Fair, where they showed off all of the new figures that they're going to be releasing this year, and there's a lot of really great information in that video. And hey, if you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to like it and hit that subscribe button so that way you don't miss out on any of my other reviews. I would really appreciate it. Until next time, my friends.